Today, I will explain why you should use dependency injection in your code and how to implement it in Laravel. Let's start with the theory. What is dependency injection? It is a technique used to reduce hard-coded dependencies in your code. Take a look at this example. Here, the service class you want to use is instantiated directly within a method. This means the code is now dependent on a specific implementation of the service, which is known as tight coupling. Now, let's look at an example with dependency injection. In this case, the dependency is passed to the constructor and automatically resolved by Laravel. You can then use it like this in your code. In many situations in Laravel, dependencies can also be passed as method parameters. You may have used this feature without even realizing it. For example, using default request class. Okay, now let's explain the difference. Why is the second approach better than the first? Instantiating a class directly within the code causes problems, especially with testing. If you understand how automated tests work, you are probably aware of these issues. If not, I'll explain briefly. Let's say you want to test this code automatically. You write a test that checks whether the output for a given input matches the expected result. In this case, the test will call the method, executing everything inside it. Inside the method, a ChatGPT API instance is created. This class is responsible for fetching data from OpenAI's API, and here's the problem. We don't want to make real API calls during testing. OpenAI's API isn't free, and since your code may be tested many times, avoiding unnecessary API calls is crucial to prevent unnecessary charges. The second problem is that, in a test, all possible scenarios should be covered. However, OpenAI's API generally works, and we don't want to wait for a moment when it fails to test that scenario. The conclusion is simple. While testing, we want to control the response of the OpenAI dependency to verify whether the rest of the logic works correctly. However, in a typical setup, we can only modify the input and check whether the output is as expected. This is where dependency injection helps. By injecting dependencies, usually through a class constructor, we can replace them with a so-called mock during testing. A mock allows us to specify what the dependency should return. If we depend on abstractions rather than concrete implementations, testing becomes even easier because we can create a fake implementation and pass it in. More details on this will be covered in the video about testing. In summary, using dependency injection makes it easy to manipulate dependency responses, improving code testability. Without it, testing code properly becomes much harder, or even impossible, if we want to follow the principles of unit testing. But dependency injection is useful for more than just testing. When you use dependency injection, your code becomes easier to reuse. You can easily share services across multiple parts of the application, and if you want to follow solid principles, it's the easiest way to achieve the single responsibility principle. Most often, you will use dependency injection in controllers and service classes. You can pass dependencies to the constructor, and Laravel will automatically create an instance. If you want to write it more concisely, you can add an access modifier before the parameter. This way, you don't need to use this, but that's just a visual difference. Both approaches work fine. In some cases, dependencies can also be passed as method parameters. For example, if you need dependency injection in a command class, passing it as a method parameter is a better approach. Otherwise, using it in a constructor would require calling the parent constructor, which doesn't look clean. Your service classes may also have dependencies, and they should be resolved automatically as well. Another key use case for dependency injection is passing interfaces instead of specific implementations. Let's modify the previous example. Now, instead of using the ChatGPT API service directly, I will use the AI chat interface and bind the ChatGPT API service to this interface. This is necessary because Laravel needs to know what should be instantiated. However, this approach has several advantages. For this part of the code, it doesn't matter how the service works, it just needs responses. Whether the chat service used is ChatGPT, Gemini, or something else is irrelevant here because it only adds some text to the generated response. Using an interface instead of a specific service allows us to switch implementations easily by changing just one line of code. Additionally, you can add logic to determine which service should be used based on specific conditions. For example, you could select a service based on API usage, taking advantage of multiple free tier plans that provide similar functionality, or for any other reason. There are many situations where dependency injection is useful. Let's look at another example. Imagine you were given the task of integrating with a chat API, and you wrote the code without using dependency injection. After some time, someone assigns you the task of switching to a different implementation of the API. Since the initial solution was tightly coupled to a specific implementation, you now have to go through the code, find all instances where the old API was instantiated, and replace it with the new one. However, if you had used dependency injection and programmed to an interface rather than a specific implementation, this change would be much easier. You would only need to modify the binding in one place, and the rest of the application would remain unaffected. Dependency injection provides more flexibility and makes it easier to manage changes in the code, reducing the risk of introducing errors when implementing new services. So, if you're not using it yet, now is the time to start.